Now, actually, the wave number E, this wave, is actually sum of C and D. Similarly, same I've written here, AC cos omega CT. AC cos omega CT is our wave number D, right? I've written it. Separate carrier. I have already told you that D and B are the same waves. AC cos omega CT plus C, wave number C, which is empty into cos omega CT, or general empty into AC cos omega CT, right? Now what I did was AC cos omega CT common 1 plus m of t. I have written this cos omega CT on this side. I can write it as AC 1 plus mt cos omega CT. Now actually, if I talk about this, this is the general equation. Now if I draw the Fourier spectrum, it will be similar, it will be same as this, but the only thing that will be added will be the carrier component. Now if I go back, this is again the carrier component which I talked about it in D, wave number D, AC cos omega CT, single tone wave. It is the amplitude will now be divided by 2 because cos omega CT is equal to e raised per j omega CT plus e raised per minus j omega CT divided by 2, right? Now AC by 2, now AC by 2. Now the double sideband full carrier is simply the addition of the wave C and wave D. Now I am adding these two waves, this and this, the similarly same will be replicated here. This one, the only difference will be now the amplitude will be here. MT into AC is the maximum amplitude into cos omega CT. Now if I open it in terms of E, it'll be E raised per j omega CT plus E raised per minus j omega CT divided by 2. Now the maximum amplitude will be m of 0 into AC divided by 2, which is here m of naught AC divided by 2. Similarly on this side, m of naught AC divided by 2, the carrier term will be same, AC by 2. The bandwidth will also be same because we have not touched with the bandwidth, we have only added these two signals. Now the question arises, why do we similarly say here it is empty into cos omega CT, my carrier was AC into cos omega CT, my carrier AC is a constant term, right? Now I am doing amplitude model. I am varying the amplitude of carrier with respect to massive signal. Here you can see simply the amplitude is now m of t, which is variable and which is varying with respect to message signal. This is actually cos omega CT, right? You can see the blue one is the wave, right is the dotted, okay? Blue one is the wave. This is cos omega CT. That means wave number B and C have same frequencies. The only difference is here the amplitude is varying, and most importantly, amplitude is varying with respect to message signal. That's why amplitude modulation. Here as well, you can see AC into 1 plus m of t, same, the amplitude is varying with respect to message signal, but it's varying differently. This is AC into 1 plus m of t. That means AC is varying, that means cos omega CT is varying. Now the variation is different. Here the difference was the wave was starting from 2, here now the wave is starting from 3. Now the question lies, why do we do this double sideband full carrier? The answer lies in the envelope detector, envelope detection, which will be discussed in the next lecture. Why do we do double sideband full carrier when we don't need it? Now let me brief you about the efficiency. See, this is my message signal, right? I want to transmit this signal. I'm using carrier because this is a low energy signal, right? Now I energize it for long distance transmission. Now what I get it? I get the message signal back in the double sideband full carrier. In the double sideband suppressed carrier. In the double sideband full carrier, I get this message signal back, but I do get this AC by 2, which is the carrier component. This I want my message signal. When I do the detection, I want my message signal back, not the carrier signal. That's why I waste my power on this signal, on this spike, AC by 2 spike. This is of no use at the detection point. but I waste 66.6% of power on my AC by 2, whereas I need to only transmit this signal. That's why we say that the double sideband suppressed carrier has 100% efficiency in terms of power, because I'm utilizing all the power on sending the message signal. However, for double sideband full carrier, I'm utilizing power for sending the message signal as well as sending separate component of AC by 2 or separate component of carrier. Now, why do we send the separate component of carrier in double sideband full carrier? It's got a very good use, but it will be discussed in the envelope detection section. Thank you for watching. That's all from Inayat.